One that really stands out is Nick and Danny Ballard.
Well, the biggest problem was he was spending a dollar to make a dime.
They were in a tough spot.
Really tough.
I've always had the dream to have my own mine. I would like to build a golden empire, if you will, but I realize that's a long way from where I'm at now.
Mine boss Nick Ballard staked his $10,000 life savings on a 180-acre mine in the hostile Arizona desert.
So here's the beast, huh?
That's the beast. It was out of my budget to drill wells or haul water, and just it's dry, 100%.
Essential in the arid desert, Nick's dry plant uses air rather than water to blow away the dirt from the gold.
So did you build this entirely by yourself, Nick?
For the most part. You'll have to pardon the rudimentary 55-gallon drum. That's just what I was able to scrounge up.
Let's fire it up.
Let's do it.
Juan and myself will just kind of stand back and
take a nap.
See what goes on, yeah.
No.
All right.
We'll watch it for sure.
This is part of what's killing me. You know, gas is not cheap. Diesel's not cheap. So it's skin of my teeth every time. Fire it up.
The plant requires as much as $850 in fuel per month, a heavy cost for an already cash-strapped operation.
All right, first bucket.
They were completely out of resources.
You know, and when it's a struggle day to day just to have enough gas to put into
the generator,
all that weight is on Nick's shoulders to be able to survive.
A lot on his plate.
Yeah. Some of the challenges that we had, the fixes that we had to come up with, you know, we ended up with a lot of new fixes we've never done before.
Mm-hmm. All through the season.
Yeah.
If this fails, I'm in big trouble.
Shut her down, Nick.
After 4 hours, time is called on the dry plant test run.
You know, in that first gold weigh that we had, how much was it, Fred?
Nothing to speak of. Maybe $10 worth of gold.
Yeah. Not that great.
That's a tough one right there.
Yeesh.
Not even worth the diesel he put in for his excavator. Not even close.
Mm-mm.
You need better ground, you know, because you're not running a ton of material.
Mm-hmm. You know, this gulch you're playing with right here, this is the last one I would touch here. You're not getting enough gold to pay for the diesel, and that doesn't cut it. So we're going to try to save you money and get your efficiency up.
Okay.
I'm no solar expert, but you've got a lot of solar here.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Not a problem out here.
In an ambitious first, Freddy and Juan design a bespoke solar panel trailer to power Nick's dry plant, with the dream to make all of his gold pure profit.
I'm just getting started on this solar trailer. This is my first adventure with anything over a solar panel about that big, right? But that's how you learn. If you don't strive to learn new things, you never jump ahead.
In a turn of fortune, the Ballards' hope for a solar-powered mining solution already lies in Nick's workshop.
There's a family, huh?
Right, yeah.
Let's go meet them.
Aww. This is Irie and my wife, Mikey.
Mikey, how you doing? I'm Juan.
Juan, I'm
nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. Oh, hello, little
That's
one.
That's Irie.
Hi, cutie.
I missed you guys. Oh, I missed you so much.
Yeah. Nick, he's very caring, very passionate about what he does. He definitely sacrifices a lot. It's definitely hard being here without him while he mines quite often, but I'm behind him 100%.
The family went fully solar just over a year ago.
Here's the workhorse, and that provides power all the time during the day. The sun's shining, we got all the power we need. So yeah, without this thing, we were running the generator.
Oh man. And are these new or are they used?
They're used.
They're, used,
they're pretty new, though.
Well, this is half the battle, finding the panels, so.
Yeah, awesome.
That's great, you got them.
Yeah.
Well, let's get them loaded up, huh?
There you go. All right.
The reality is, if they would have kept on running there, they would have lost a lot more money in operational costs. Let's go.
Nick, let's bring a panel over. Hey, Danny, you want to hop up inside of there?
You got it.
He doesn't have to run that generator.
Oh, yeah. You know, he's got to drive 25 miles into town to go get gas. And savings there alone is going to be huge for him.
Mm-hmm. Keep going, coming.
Go.
Chalk the wheels there. Home sweet home.
So this is our standalone solar system that we built. It's on a trailer, so it's mobile. It's real simple. You know, it's kind of a real quick build, but we got six panels on it. Six panels that come to this charge system. This charge system is charging four batteries that are 6 volts apiece. Ultimately, it's 24 volts total that we're running out of this system. So the 24 volt battery packs go to an inverter. This inverter is able to supply about 4,000 watts of power. And then we have three outlets right here. On top of that, when Freddy built the frame, he made these panels adjustable so that way we could kind of adjust the panels so they get the maximum sunlight, so they produce the maximum energy. But my favorite part of this whole system is that it's portable. You hook it up to a truck or a UTV, put it wherever you want it, get power right where you need it.
These solar generators sure come in handy for, you know, not having to put as much fuel in the generator. So looking forward to that. Maybe I'll survive just yet.
And now he can run that plant day and night with the battery backup. It basically runs itself.
Exactly. That was a first for us, so I'm kind of proud
of
that
too,
one.
As well.
Yeah.
All right, watch out, guys. Trauma's gonna start up.
Yeah.
That's pretty sweet. Well, 4 hour test. Here we go, huh?
Oh, mate. Look at that.
Able to produce 4,000 watts of power, Freddy and Juan's brand new creation turns the 6 foot trommel.
Drive's running good, punch plate's running good, and the solar trailer's running everything.
Yeah, the solar system, I think, is awesome. Ran that plant, you know, for the full test run, not an issue, and really it's low light.
A cloudy day.
Yeah.
First cloudy day we've had, that's the day we ran. So that proves it right there that it's working.
Yeah, it'll do it. We did good.
You know, it'll allow those guys to add more blow boxes on the end of that in the future.
I think a big part of what we did there, Fred, is reduce the running cost. By building that solar trailer, basically the trommel itself runs on its own.
Mm-hmm.
No fuel needed.
You know, it took a little bit of initial investment,
yeah,
but in the end,
it's going to pay itself off.
It'll pay for itself.
The fixes quadrupled Nick's profit, and the solar trailer gave enough power to run the whole operation with little expenditure.
That's a really good increase, guys. I really appreciate it.
All baloney aside, I would move downstream. He was at the very top of a drainage, mm-hmm, that had barely had any erosion, but down below, all those, mm-hmm, drainages concentrated down there, and it kind of went down like this and then flattened out just a little bit down there.
Yeah.
So it's a perfect catch for gold.
Yeah. Well, I'm really hoping that he moved the plant, got it down to where it needs to be, mm-hmm, and maybe he's got some good news for us. Hey, Nick, how
Hi,
you
Nick.
Doing?
Good, you?
Good, buddy.
So how's everything working out for you on mining?
I did move it a little further down. There was that other little draw just to the west from where we were running.
Okay.
It doubled the gold. I've probably at least doubled the volume, too. Did some work on that screen and got four boxes underneath there now. Once I implemented those, it's been off to the races.
Good.
So I got actually some gold drying up from a couple hours last time I was out there.
Yeah,
we can see it good.
How's the solar trailer doing?
Man, that thing is awesome. I can do all my fabrication off of it. I can run the plant.
Nice.
Lights at night when I've got to run at night when it's too hot during the day. So that thing is awesome.
Cool.
Good to hear.
Glad it worked out.
You know, our big goal was to be able to reduce your running cost.
Oh, 100%. You guys were definitely able to accomplish less cost for me and less sweat equity, I suppose. That solar trailer, man, it is something else.
Good. How's Danny doing?
He's working on his little landscaping and figuring out where he wants to put his house.
Nice.
So how's the family doing?
Let me go get him. 1 second.
Well, hi, guys.
Golden Nugget number one and Golden Nugget number two.
There
Very
you cool.
go. Hello, little ones.
Can you say hi to Freddy and Juan?
You know, that's the whole reason we do what we do right there. You know, we work hard for our families to give them a future, so good on you.
Yep, exactly. I think the common thread between all the miners we've helped, Juan, is you got somebody that looks to better things for their family and their future.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a win-win, Juan.
It was a win.